My name is Sabrina Rivera, and I'm a civil slash water resources engineer at Arcadis, and I work on water resources projects and water infrastructure.
Ever since she was a child, Sabrina has been curious about nature and the world around her.
Growing up in Southern California, there's always been a drought or water issues, and something that's kind of been in the back of my mind always.
And now as a civil engineer, Sabrina works on getting clean water to people in the city of Los Angeles.
Civil engineers build pretty much everything you see around you in cities.
Civil engineers build buildings, roads, and bridges. But did you know that civil engineers also do a lot of things that you can't see?
For instance, I work on water projects, and we don't see pipelines, we don't see the pumps that go behind all of it, but we turn on the faucet and there's water.
You can thank civil engineers every time you are able to get clean water to your house to drink, to cook, or to take a bath. But how do civil engineers get the water to be so clean? And how does the water get to your house?
When we look at water treatment, we try to replicate the water cycle and look to see what nature does.
So what exactly is the water cycle? Well, the water cycle is the way that water naturally gets around the earth. The water cycle starts when it rains. When the rain lands on the ground, it seeps through the earth. Different layers of earth have different sized sediments. As the water seeps through the earth, it is cleaned. This makes the water clean and drinkable for humans and animals. People build wells that go deep into the earth to reach the water, and this works great when there's a lot of places to build the wells. But what happens in cities where there are a lot of people who all need clean water? The water cycle can't make enough clean water for all the people who need to drink it. Thankfully, we have civil engineers to make dirty water clean.
Filters are used to remove compounds or chemicals from the water that would make us sick or make the water dirty. So the different parts of a filter are designed to remove different parts of pollutants from the water.
Filters start out with really big holes to remove the big stuff. After that, the water will go through smaller and smaller holes to remove the smaller stuff. When we look at this filter, the holes are the spaces in between the different materials making up the layers. These are called pores. And the bigger the pores are, the more stuff there is that can get through it. This is just like the water cycle. Do you remember how the water was cleaned as it seeped through the ground and through the different layers of sediment? In some filters, the holes are so small that everything bigger than those tiny holes gets left behind, even some bacteria. This makes the water super clean. So how do civil engineers know if their filter is working?
So we test to make sure that filters are working by conducting actual tests where we take samples of water before it goes through the filter and when it comes out of the filter. And there's so much in the world and so much information, you know, you just want to keep exploring and find something that you're really interested in.
Ready to build your own water filter? Check out the challenge on Curiosity Machine.